Smart objects can save us time, storage space, and provide greater flexibility when editing. Let's find out what they're all about.
The term smart objects may sound like marketing hype, but this is how Photoshop allows you to work non-destructively with individual layers. Adjustments made to the smart object layer can be reversed at a later date with no loss in image quality. In the previous chapter, we talked about the benefits of working with vectors. Smart objects allow you to bring in vector graphics that were created outside of Photoshop without having to convert them to pixels. Let's begin with our Chapter 9 folder inside our Project Files folder and open the File Twirl Vessel 2. Gonna go to full screen mode with menu bar by pressing the F key. We'll zoom in a bit here. Notice in our Layers panel, nestled between the background layer and the shape layer, we have a smart object. How do we know it's a smart object? Because the smart object icon is located in the bottom right of that image thumbnail. I'll toggle the image off and on so you can see what this smart object is. It is the flowers in the vase. Now, smart objects simply link or reference source files. It's not a file itself, it's pointing to an original file. In this case, the original flowers file is an Illustrator document. Now, before smart objects came along, when you placed an Illustrator file in Photoshop, the image was automatically rasterized. And we saw back in Chapter 8 what happens when you resize raster images. I'm going to select this smart object and go to the Edit menu and select Free Transform. Now, if I click and drag on our transform box and make the image smaller, I'll zoom in at 100% view. Because it's a vector graphic, we don't lose any image quality. I'll zoom back out again. If we changed our mind and said, oops, we didn't want to make it smaller, we wanted to go back closer to the original size, I simply go back to the Edit menu, Free Transform, and now we'll drag this and enlarge it. Right about there. I'll hit Enter to commit. And because this is a vector graphic, at 100% view, we still have nice, clean lines. I mentioned that this smart object is referencing an Illustrator file. Here's another cool thing you can do with smart objects. If I move to the Layers panel and double-click on the smart object icon, Photoshop automatically launches Illustrator where the file was originally created, and you can see our source file. If you get a warning about color settings, just click Continue. And if you don't have Illustrator, you can just sit back and watch. Now that it's in Illustrator, I'm going to make two quick changes to the image. You can simply watch what I'm doing, or you can follow along. If you'd like to follow along here, note that I have the color panel open. You can find the color panel under the window menu. With the direct selection tool, I'm going to select these orange petals and select all of them with the same fill color and change this to blue. I'll select these petals. And let's change these to a bright yellow. Now I'm going to save the Illustrator file. Watch what happens when I go back into Photoshop. Our smart object automatically updates to reflect the changes that we've just made. So if you work with images moving back and forth between Photoshop and Illustrator or another program, smart objects are going to save you a lot of time. You simply make your change to the document in its originating program, and Photoshop automatically updates the contents.